A cup of Indonesia, the world's premium coffee. Coffee. Who can resist the temptation to enjoy this special drink? Coffee has reached all walks of life and has become a lifestyle for the urban community. Coffee is a mainstay of plantation commodities in Indonesian economy and constitutes a contributor of the country's non-oil and non-gas foreign exchange revenues. To date, approximately 95% of Indonesia's coffee crop is cultivated by smallholders, whereas state and private plantations cultivate approximately 5%. Coffee production in Indonesia for the period of 2001 to 2010 is dominated by Robusta coffee, 86.89%, and Arabica coffee, 13.11%. Talking about the environmental aspect, the coffee plantations are known as a good provider of groundwater and absorb carbon dioxide by releasing oxygen. There are more than 60 different varieties of coffee in the world, but only two types of coffee have high commercial value, namely Arabica and Robusta coffee. Arabica coffee is grown only on land that has an altitude above 1,000 meters. This coffee species has the most delicious taste and higher price, while Robusta coffee can be grown on land that is not too high. This type of coffee is known for its bitter and sour taste. Robusta coffee has more affordable price and has higher caffeine content. Indonesia is the world's fourth biggest coffee producer. The development of coffee product export during the period of 1996 to 2010 also experiences an average growth of 2.98% per year. Most of coffee products are still in the form of green beans. Besides that, Indonesia will also export coffee in the form of roasted coffee. The following are some well-known specialty coffees of Arabica species in Indonesia. Gayo coffee, which can be found at Gayo Highlands, Nangro Aceh, Darussalam Province. Mandheling coffee, which can be found at Bukit Barisan, North Sumatra Province. Lintong coffee, which can be found at Bukit Barisan, North Sumatra Province. Java coffee, which can be found at the crater of Ijen, East Java Province. Preanger coffee, which can be found in Pangalengan, West Java Province. Toraja coffee, which can be found in Tanah Toraja, South Sulawesi Province. Kalosi coffee, which can be found in Tanah Toraja, South Sulawesi Province. Bali Kintamani coffee, which can be found at Kintamani Highlands, Bali Province. Bajawa Flores coffee, which can be found at Flores Highlands, Nusa Tenggara Timur Province. Baliem coffee, which can be found in Paniai and Jayawijaya, West Papua Province. The following are some well-known specialty coffees of Robusta species in Indonesia. Java Robusta, which can be found in Central Java and East Java provinces. Bali Robusta, which can be found in Pupuan, Bali Province. Lampung Robusta, which can be found at Bukit Barisan, Lampung Province. Flores Robusta, which can be found on the island of Flores. The first sample of specialty coffee that will be discussed this time is Bali Kintamani coffee. Bali is also known as the Island of the Gods and the Island of a Thousand Temples. Besides the tourist attraction, Bali has great potential in developing coffee commodity. Bali coffee variety has various advantages, such as having higher yield potential, more resistant to pests, and have unique flavor. Local people refer to it as kopiol. Bali Kintamani coffee plantation is located at Kintamani Highlands, with an altitude of 1,000 up to 1,500 meters above sea level. This plantation is located at Mount Batur, which has fertile soil, dry climate, cool air, and is located close to the equator. Kintamani coffee is Arabica coffee species, which has good aroma and taste with medium to high acidity, rich flavor, and a touch of citrus flavor. Kintamani Arabica coffee cultivation is entirely organic, starting from fertilization up to the use of natural insecticide. Coffee plants generally require shade trees. Treatment such as pruning is carried out when the plant is 3 to 4 years old. Kintamani coffee plant has a unique fruit shape because its branches are hanging down and touching the ground, different from other coffee species. Coffee beans are harvested by picking the ripe beans. Ripe coffee bean is marked by the changes of its skin color. The color of the skin is dark green when the coffee bean is still young, yellow when it's almost ripe, and red when it's fully ripe, and becomes blackish when it's overripe. Coffee berries are harvested by means of selective picking. Only the ripe berries are picked. In general, Kintamani coffee plantation also performs the mixed farming technique. In Kintamani coffee plantations, the plant that is normally planted together with coffee plants is orange trees.
Sebelum ada MPIG, kopi Kintamani cukup murah sekali. Nah, mulai tahun 2002 dirintislah suatu perkumpulan dari beberapa subak-subak yang difasilitasi oleh dinas sehingga tahun 2008 disertifikasi yaitu sertifikasi indikasi geografis. Nah, dengan adanya sertifikasi indikasi geografis ini, harga kopi Kintamani cukup memuaskan.
From Kintamani, now we are heading to Pupuan Bali. This region has an altitude from 500 to 900 meters. In addition to coffee, rice farming in the agricultural sector in this region constitutes the main source of income for its inhabitants. With dry climate and fertile soil located in the mountainous region, the coffee that grows in this region is categorized as Robusta specialty coffee. Robusta Bali coffee has mild Robusta flavor, not too bitter, as well as rich and long-lasting flavor in the mouth. Different from Arabica coffee that generally uses propagation from seed or variety, Pupuan Robusta coffee uses vegetative or clone system. There is a nursery bed for Pupuan Robusta coffee to maintain its quality. After the clone has reached the age of 8 months, it can be transplanted in the coffee plantation. The cultivation of Pupuan Robusta coffee is fully organic. In general, coffee growers work together with livestock ranch owners so that they can use the cattle manure as fertilizer for the coffee plants. Treatment such as pruning can be carried out when the plants reach the age of 3 to 4 years. Pruning is essential for the coffee plants in order to have high productivity. Coffee berries are harvested by means of selective picking. Only the ripe berries are picked. Robusta coffee plantations at Pupuan, Bali also implement mixed farming technique. The plant which is generally cultivated together with coffee in Robusta coffee plantations is cocoa.
Sebelum kami mendapat bantuan di tahun 2007, kami mengolah sistem asalan dengan gelondong yang dikeringkan dengan asalan. Nah, dengan respon dari pemerintah pusat melalui Dinas Provinsi Perkebunan Bali, kami di tahun 2007 diarahkan mengolah basah dengan bantuan berupa mesin haler dan mesin pulper serta washer. Kami juga diberbantukan dengan air permukaan di tahun 2009. Nah, akhirnya kami di Subak Abian bisa ngolah semaksimal mungkin. Akhirnya mutu yang kita harapkan bisa menjangkau dan meningkatkan kualitas kopi.
Bolo marhapo san putihi susi nang pasumbu.
Besides Bali, North Sumatra has two production centers for producing Arabica species specialty coffee. One of them is Lintong coffee. Lintong, also known as Lintong Nihuta, is a district in Humbang Hasundutan Regency, North Sumatra, located on the south of Lake Toba. This area is located at Bukit Barisan Highlands. Lintong is at an altitude between 1,300 to 1,600 meters above sea level. With wet climate and fertile mountainous soil, Lintong coffee has an excellent aroma and rich taste, as well as medium acidity and great flavor. Arabica Lintong coffee is one of the specialty coffees in Indonesia. The cultivation of Lintong coffee also uses shady trees. As with other organic crops, fertilization is carried out only by using manure and compost made from coffee processing waste. Harvesting these coffee berries is carried out by picking ripe coffee berries, or by means of selective picking, picking only the ripe red coffee berries. Lintong coffee plantations implements the mixed farming technique. The plants which are normally cultivated together with coffee plant in Arabica coffee plantations are tamarillo and chili.
APKLU, Asosiasi Petani Kopi Lintong Organik, sudah pernah mendapatkan sertifikasi internasional tahun 2005 sampai tahun 2011 ya. Namanya Fair Trade Labeling Organization dari Bonn, Jerman, sertifikasi internasional yang sudah cukup diakui untuk pemberdayaan masyarakat atau petani kecil. Ini salah satunya produk dari produsen APKLU yang dijual di Jepang. Ada banyak keuntungan yang bisa didapat petani dengan sistem ini. Mereka bisa jadi mandiri, belajar tentang bisnis, ya, dan juga ya mereka mendapatkan harga yang lebih fair, ya, yang lebih adil dengan sistem ini, ya.
Now we are heading to the south to Mandheling. Mandheling, also known as Mandheling Natal, is a regency in North Sumatra. This region is known worldwide as a producer of high-quality coffee, dated back from long time ago. In general, Mandheling coffee has similarity to the other Arabica coffees from Sumatra. This coffee has a distinctive sweet aroma and it is the thickest coffee in the world. For this reason, coffee drinkers do not need to mix Mandheling coffee with other coffee to make it thick. Mandheling coffee had been exported to America and Europe before World War II. Mandheling is also known for its gold because Sumatra has a huge source of gold. It is no wonder that Sumatra is also known as Swarna Dwipa or the Gold Island. Unlike coffee plantations in Kintamani and Lintong, Mandheling coffee is mostly planted on the mountain slopes with an altitude of 1,300 to 1,500 meters above sea level. With this pattern of cultivation, some wild civets often consume ripe coffee berries and produce luwak coffee, which is famous worldwide. Coffee berries are harvested by means of selective picking, namely picking the ripe coffee berries only. Mandheling coffee plantation implements mixed farming technique. The plants which are normally cultivated together with coffee at Mandheling coffee plantation are ginger and garlic. Lanang coffee or pea berry coffee is called lanang because the shape of the coffee seed is different from that of the other coffee species. It is called lanang because the shape of the coffee seed is not divided and rounded, not split like the shape of coffee beans in general. However, actually it is not a new variety of coffee. Lanang coffee can be produced by both Robusta coffee species and Arabica coffee species, which is generally cultivated by farmers in Indonesia. Lanang coffee is actually the result of normal coffee sorting during the harvest to produce lanang coffee beans. Luwak coffee is coffee which is brewed using the ingredient of coffee beans taken from the droppings of civets or palm civets. This coffee bean is believed to have a different taste after being eaten by the civet and passed through the civet's digestive tract. The popularity of this coffee in Southeast Asia has long been known, but it becomes widely known among gourmet coffee enthusiasts after a publication in the 1980s. The luwak coffee beans are the most expensive in the world, with prices reaching $100 per 450 grams. Civets once were considered pests by farmers, but now civets are left alone, and they are even being taken care of by coffee growers. Civets like to search for ripe fruits to eat, including coffee beans. With a sensitive sense of smell, civets pick fully ripe coffee berries as their food. Because coffee beans have hard skin which protects them, the coffee beans will come out undigested together with civet's droppings. This happens because the civet has a simple digestive system, so hard food like coffee bean is not digested. To date, many coffee growers have searched for the luwak coffee beans because they believe that the beans originate from the finest coffee beans that have been fermented naturally in the civet's digestive system. The aroma and taste of luwak coffee is special and perfect among coffee enthusiasts and coffee lovers around the world. Luwak coffee beans found in civet's droppings are collected, washed, roasted, grounded, and brewed using hot water to create luwak coffee.
Nah, setelah proses akan nanti seperti ini. Sini kita keringkan dulu, langsung kita cuci. Nah, setelah dicuci nanti kopi luwak itu akan kita dapat pisahkan dengan pea berry. Atau yang disebut kopi lanang biji tunggal. Nah, hasilnya nanti seperti ini. Dari kopi luwak yang non pea berry, kopi luwak yang pea berry, kopi luwak lanang kalau di Bali disebut kopi muani, itu sangat diburu dari pasaran dunia.
After harvesting coffee berries, they are processed by using the wet process method. We do this by putting the coffee berries into a water tank to be washed and to remove stones or materials other than coffee. In this stage, the good coffee berries will sink below the water surface, whereas the coffee berries which are of lower quality will float on the surface of the water. Only the best coffee berries will be processed in the second stage. The second stage is removing the skin of the coffee berries and the layer of the berries with the help of depulping machines. Upon completion of this stage, the coffee bean layer still exists. The duration of the fermentation process depends on the market demand, which is usually 12, 24, or 36 hours. After the fermentation process is completed, the coffee beans are washed. The fourth stage is the drying process. It is usually carried out to dry the coffee beans under the sun or by using drying machines until the moisture reaches 11 to 13%. The next process is separating the coffee beans from their husk by using the huller machine. The next stage is classification. The coffee beans are washed again to remove dirt from the previous drying process. Then, the coffee beans in the form of green beans are grouped based on the size of the coffee beans and their physical qualities. The machine used for this purpose is Sutton machine. Subsequently, the beans are classified by their grades. After that, the coffee beans are packed and shipped pursuant to the consumer's demand. At this stage, the green coffee beans or green beans are ready to be exported or sent to the roasting process. Before the roasting process, green beans are cleaned from the dirt caused by the previous process. After that, the beans are ready to enter the roasting process. This process can directly enhance the flavor and color of coffee beans. Physically, the changes in the coffee beans can be observed, such as dried coffee beans and decrease in overall weight. The pores on the surface of the bean can be seen more clearly. The color of the coffee beans will also turn into dark brown. Indonesia is one of the best coffee-producing countries in the world, with special characteristics that cannot be found in other types of coffee. This is due to the soil type, plantation altitude, coffee types, processing methods, and age. Indonesian coffee also has a long history of more than 300 years. Therefore, Indonesian coffee has captured the heart of the world community since long time ago. The government's programs also support farmers in improving the productivity of coffee plants, which results in better quality control of Indonesian coffee and an average growth rate of 2.8% per year. That is why Indonesian coffee is your best choice and can also become your investment. A cup of Indonesia, the world's premium coffee.